As a high school student, it is possible for you to overlook, or not even to take notice at all, the number of senior adults that live all around you. Yet their numbers are growing at historic rates. Some social scientists project that over the next 20 years, the number of senior adults living in America will grow 3 times faster than the rest of the population. So, what is their life stage like? We briefly address some of the major life stages of childhood, adolescence, and even early and middle adulthood. But later adulthood is also very significant for sociological studies. Why? Well, first, because of the growing number they represent in our society. Secondly, because of the impact that they have on so many of the social institutions, such as many of them are working later and later in years, which impacts the composition of the labor force. Others are engaging in new forms of recreation, which can change the landscape of many communities. Just think of the cultural influence this has had on the state of Florida. And with age, oftentimes comes health issues. So a growing population of adults in their later years also has significant impact on the healthcare system of our society. So as you were reading your section for today, you want to keep in mind this main idea. Americans entering the later years or old age face a new set of life transitions, challenges, and opportunities. So as you were reading, you want to be able to answer questions like this. What changes characterize later adulthood? Now, related to this, you want to be able to differentiate between what sociologists refer to as young olds, middle olds, and old olds. Secondly, what new opportunities do older Americans enjoy? So, to be able to understand the material from this section, I recommend that you use the plan, reading, and note-taking strategy. We've used this before in several other sections. First thing that you want to do before you even begin to start to read the section is P, predict the main idea. So in the middle rectangle, you want to write changes in later adulthood. This is the main idea for this section. Next, what you want to do is you want to locate L, the key points. These are your subheadings, the statements that are in red. So, what changes have occurred? Well, in this section, we see 3 main subheadings that explain the changes in later adulthood. First, you would end up having retirement. You also have physical and mental functioning. And you also have the changes in coping with dependency and death. Now, the next thing you want to do is A. You want to add information. At this point, you have a skeleton of this section. Now, what you want to do is give it some meat. So, now is when you want to begin to start to read through the section. And as you read through the section, add details that will help you understand the key points. For example, under the physical and mental functioning, there are several very important bits of information that are in that section. So what I would do is I would recommend that you would include definitions for dementia, Alzheimer's, and also the physical changes that take place to the body. Now go through and continue to do this for the rest of this section, and you'll have a good understanding of some of the transitions, some of the challenges, and some of the opportunities that take place in the later years.